Hello everyone. So continuing our discussions on the service time and the service mechanism. Service times of the successive arrivals are denoted by S1, S2, Sn and so on, and they may be either constant or of random duration. When S1, S2, Sn is usually characterized as a sequence of independent and identically distributed random variables. The exponential, wave, gamma, log normal and truncated normal distributions have all been used successfully as models of service times in different situations. A queuing system consists of a number of service centers and interconnecting queues. Each service center consists of some number of servers C working in parallel. That is, upon getting to the head of the line of the customer, takes the first available server. Parallel service mechanism are either single server or multi-server or unlimited servers. A self-service facility is usually characterized as having an unlimited number of servers. So, once we are familiar with all the characteristics of the queuing model, then we go how actually the queuing notations are used. So, what are the special types of notations which are used in order to represent the queuing models? So, Kendall's. So, here we make use of a notation called as Kendall's notation. So this Kendall's proposal, a notation, is a notation system for parallel server system which has been widely adopted, and a bridge version of this convention is based on the format A, B, C and K. These letters represent the following system characteristics. A, what is A here? A represents the inter-arrival time distributions. B represents the service time distribution. C represents the number of parallel servers, and N represents the system capacity. K represents the size of the calling population. So once again, I'm going to repeat it. A, B, C, N, K. So this is the typical Kendall's notation. So these characters will represent some values. So here we can see A, it represents the inter-arrival time distribution. B represents the service time distribution. C represents the number of parallel servers. N represents the system capacity, and K represents the size of the calling population. So this is how we are going to denote the queuing models. So after this, we are in the last topic of our second module's first part. So here we are, I'm going to explain you on the long run measures of the performance of the queuing system. So how we are going to check the performance measures of the queuing models or the queuing systems. So the primary long run measures of performance of the queuing systems are the long runtime average number of customer in system, that is L and Q, that is LQ. So average number of customers and Q. So L and LQ. The long run average time spent in the system, W, waiting time, that is W in the queue, WQ, per customer. Server utilization or population of time that a server is busy, that is P. So once we are familiar with these variables like M, L, LQ, W, WQ and P. So L is in the system, if the customer is in the system, and LQ is if the customer is in the waiting line. Then similarly, the service time also, like the long run average time spent in the system will be waiting, that is W, if it is in the system, and if it is in the queue, it is WQ per customer. Server utilization or population of the time that a server is busy will be given by small p. Time average number in system, L. Consider a queuing system over a period of time T, and let LT denote a number of customers in the system at time T. Let TI denote the total time during 0, T in which the system contained exactly I customers. So here we can see L is given by the time average number spent in the system. So that is given by the equation summation I equals to 0 to infinity I of TI by T. So this is the equation which is used to find out what is the average number, time average number a customer spends in the line or in the queue.